Let's take a look at how to complete an online assignment on Gradescope as a student. Once we log into our student account and click on a course name, we'll see all the assignments that are available for submission. In this case, it looks like there's an online exam that we haven't started yet, and we have a little over 2 hours left to start this exam. So when we click on the exam name, we'll see an introduction message that will tell us how many minutes we'll have to complete this assignment from the moment that we click start. Instructors don't always have to set a time limit, but in this case, students can start this exam any time during this 24-hour window. But once we click start and see the questions, we'll only have 60 minutes to complete them. When we're ready, let's click start. So at the top of the page, we'll see the number of questions on this exam and a countdown timer. This timer will update every minute to let us know how much time we have left to complete this assignment. If we want, we can hide the timer by clicking on the X up here. But let's keep the timer visible for now. All of the questions on the exam will be presented on a single page, but we can answer them in any order. Since this is a timed online assignment, all of our answers will be auto-saved by Gradescope, so we don't need to worry about saving each answer or losing our answers if we accidentally navigate away from the page. Note that if the instructor hadn't set a time limit for this assignment, we would not see the countdown timer, and we'd need to click a Save Answer button to submit the answers for each question. Here's an example of the interface for an untimed online assignment. All right, going back to our timed exam, let's start filling it out. We can see that this exam has various types of questions. For multiple choice questions like this one, we click the bubble of the correct answer. If there are check boxes next to the multiple choice options, we can select multiple options for the question. If there's a blank text field like here, we can type our answer into that field. Note that as we're filling out our answers, Gradescope auto-saves them, and the progress updates at the top of the screen. We can come back and update our answer to any question as many times as we'd like before the time limit expires or the due date passes. Note that if we leave the Gradescope site for any reason, the timer will continue counting down even while we're offline. For this question, the instructor has asked us to upload a file. We can select any file type from our computer, such as an image or a PDF, and upload it to Gradescope. We can preview how that file will appear to the instructor. And in this case, the instructor has also asked us to type a response, so we'll do that. All right, now all of our answers have been saved, and we can click View Submission to see how the submission will appear to the instructor. And we can click Resubmit to come back and update or add answers as many times as we'd like before the time limit expires or the due date passes. Once the assignment has been graded, we'll come back to this page and see the scores, rubrics, and feedback for each question.